Couple of icons from the Bond franchise. Yes, I said it.
Indeed,
I'd love it if you could introduce yourselves.
I'm Paul Weston, a stunt coordinator on some of the Bond films.
Incredible.
And I'm John Moreno. I played Luigi Ferrara in For Your Eyes Only.
Fantastic. Now, I have a quick question about Roger Moore. Was he a fan of dirty jokes before takes, or is that just a rumour?
Any jokes, I would think, before, whether it's dirty or not. He was very funny to work with and very amusing just to be on the set. So he made it fun. And he played a few tricks, especially on me occasionally, but yes.
Anything you care to share?
How many? just one. We were doing Roger climbing across the Indian Palace from one balcony to the other. It was about 12 feet off the floor. And I said to John Glenn, wouldn't it be good, just as he's stepping across, if we had some birds go up in front of the camera? And he said, yes, you're the pigeon wrangler. I said, thanks. So I had to get a dozen pigeons for the afternoon. So we set up the low angle camera. So I got under the camera on the box and was all ready. We got the pigeons. I had pigeon under one arm, one on the other. But one in each hand, and Roger was in position, and he said, stand by, and Roger said, hold on, I said, I'm sorry, I've got to go to the loo. So off he went. So we pigeon, back in the baskets again, waited about 7 minutes, he came back, sorry about that. So he gets back on the balcony, ready to go, I get on my box, pigeon, I'm ready to go, and he's about to step over, and as he steps over, I let the birds go up. And as all the birds went up and the feathers went everywhere, an egg came down, hit me on the head and broke over my face. He'd gone all the way, he saw the gag, gone all the way over to the canteen to get a raw egg. So that as he stepped over, he went and threw it on my head. But yes, he made life fun on there,
it did. Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah, I remember when I was, I think it was the very first scene which we meet up in the mountains, and I got the call to get to makeup and be in costume, and the car would pick me up and we'd go on location and we'd arrive there, and it was like a small terminal, and there was only the second assistant there, and I went and I said, where's everybody? He said, oh, well, they're on location, John. I said, well, where is that? He said, come to the window, you see that mountain up there? I said, yes. He said, that's where it is. And I said, well, how do we get there? Do we go by car? He said, no, we take that. And I looked, I said, what's that? He said, that's a cable car, John. And I said, oh my God. Then I looked down the window, there was this crevice and there was this huge valley and up in the mountains. And I thought, oh my God. And then Roger appeared and I went up to Roger. I said, this isn't the location, Roger. He said, yes, I know it isn't, John. And I said, the location is up on those mountains. He said, yes, I know, John. And we're going in that. He said, yes, I know, John. And I said, Roger, I'm petrified of heights, really petrified. He said, you know, I feel a little bit that way myself. He said, I tell you what we'll do. We'll get into the cable car first. We'll stand in the middle. We'll close our eyes. We'll hug each other and we'll sing a song. And I said, well, what should we sing? He said, we'll meet again. I said, that's a bit near the knuckle, isn't it? I said, well, what is it? He said, it's that old Vera Lynn song, you know. So that's exactly what happened. We got into the cable car. All the young skiers were around us, so we couldn't see out. And the door closed. There was a jolt with the cable car starting. We hugged each other, closed our eyes, and we sang, "We'll meet again, don't know where, don't know when." What the other young skiers must have thought, they said, here he is, Roger Moore, James Bond hugging a bloke in a cable car.
And singing to him.
And yeah, so that's how I got up there. I can't remember how I got down again. No. No idea.
Did you hug him on the way down as well?
I don't think we came down together. But I, it's a nightmare. I don't know how I got down. Mm. I certainly didn't ski down. But I don't know. I don't know. Anyway.
Oh, goodness me. Mm. I wanted to ask as well about what you feel is the importance of supporting roles within Bond films, because everyone focuses on Bond, but I can't help but feel that some of the most iconic characters from the James Bonds of all eras are the supporting characters he meets along the way.
Yes, absolutely. I mean, and what's been good about John Glenn, he casts very well. And you get a good cast around you, then Bond looks good. You've got to do your casting well. And I think the Bonds have done it over the years, haven't they?
I think so. I think, I think it's incredibly important. If you get a good supporting cast, then, of course, all the levels rise up. You know, it becomes a much better... It comes... Well, the quality is there to start with, isn't it? Apart from just the shots and the music, it's the quality... I don't want to bang
acting,
my own drum, but really...
No, it is the acting that brings it up.
Yeah,
absolutely. The stunts are another part of the Bond franchise that I think are so memorable and iconic. They've really helped maintain the fascination with filmmaking that I think a lot of people get from watching Bond films. What do you feel are some of the most ambitious stunts that you were a part of?
Any of the Bond stunts are ambitious one way or another. They push the envelope all the time, whether it be car crashes, rollovers, or heights, doing massive explosions like we did on For Yours Only. That's Why You Love Me in 007 stage. Just enormous action. And just to be part of it, I was really honoured to be part of the team. It is very important. When you see an advert, like a trailer for a movie, you don't see two people just saying, "I love you." You see cars crashing, explosions, and excitement into the film itself. So it makes people want to be part of that, which is, I'm proud to be a stunt person that's... helped to achieve that.
Absolutely. I think we've all probably got stories about cable cars and James Bond by the sounds of it.
Yes.
Well, there has been a couple of cable car incidents, not only For Your Eyes Only, but there was a fight between Jaws and...
That's right. I doubled Jaws jumping from one cable car to the other. It was 16 feet across. I couldn't jump 16 feet from a standing position. So what I had to do was I put a mini trampoline on the top of the cable car, and I stood on the cables themselves and up the top, and then I had to jump on this and make sure I hit it straight and central to get me 16 feet onto the other cable car. So, yes, that was a tricky one.
It's a good job you didn't have vertigo.
I didn't have vertigo at all. I live around the corner.
Goodness me. Well, listen, guys, thank you so much. I'm going to let you get back to your dinners. I believe food is imminent.
Yes, I think so.
Hope so.
I hope so.
Nice meeting you.
Really lovely to meet you as well. I'm going to come find you all later and continue this conversation. It's been really lovely to chat. Okay. So we are here with Madeline Smith and Alison Worth. Now, it's exciting to welcome both of you to the event. We're here to support John Glenn this evening and his immense legacy. But can you tell me a little bit about each of your experiences working within the Bond franchise?
Okay. I did For Your Eyes Only, and I didn't know. I went to a casting. My agent sent me to a casting. I didn't know what I was going to for. And... obviously got For Your Eyes Only, and then I had such a great time. I was in Brazil doing the premiere in Brazil, and I said to them, "Please, can I come back and do another one?" And they said, no, you're never, no, once on the Bond girl scrap, never again. Anyway, I got a call from, again, John, who said, "I think you'd be good in Octopussy," and the next thing I knew, I was flying to India, which was amazing.
That's extraordinary. Yeah. And it's a huge year for Octopussy this year as
It is, yeah. There have been lots of events, yeah.
How's it been to see the legacy of the film elevate over the decades?
Well, we were, a couple of weekends ago, we were up in Huntingdon on the train that we shot the original scene on the train. And yeah, it was incredible to see all the support and all the fans that still want to walk that train. And John was up there and we had the most incredible weekend. Yeah,
yes,
it was great.
Absolutely extraordinary. Oh, goodness me. Madeline,
yes.
If I could ask you a couple questions.
Yeah.
So I believe you were in the iconic scene with Roger Moore.
Well, I'm always in bed. Whatever I do, I seem to end up in bed. So I was in bed with Roger, and it was actually his first Bond film. Not the first scene to be shot, though, with any lady. They'd more or less finished the film when they got to me. They'd done New Orleans and everywhere else. And then they came back to freezing cold Pinewood in the January, in the actual year that it was released, 73. And did this lovely little scene. And the reason I got the part is because I had actually been in The Persuaders in an episode that Roger had directed himself and obviously thought, well, she won't fall over the furniture. She's only in bed. So I ended up as Miss Caruso.
Amazing. And it's such an iconic scene.
Yes.
Was the
bit naughty.
Very naughty. Yeah. Was it actually a magnetic gadget that he was
No, of
using?
Course not. And there was some kind of chicken wire or something down my back, you know?
Oh, little to bit pull like the zip down. Like oh, yes.
And it wouldn't go and it wouldn't pull because the dress, the fabric was so thick. So I had Roger actually was instructed to keep a diary, a day-to-day diary of the making of Live and Let Die. And he has written, I didn't realize, three people were under my frock trying to get this thing down. Wow. I mean, obviously it worked in the end and it looked so smooth and sexy, you
it
know,
did, it
looking
did.
Into each other's eyes yeah. and so on. But actually, there's a whole play going on underneath.
Yes, so iconic. That's a lot of people to fit into one closet with James Bond and a Bond girl.
Yeah, and under my frock.
Goodness me. Now tell me, what are you both looking forward to the most about this evening?
Oh, just catching. I think catching up
celebrating
with John
somebody.
And all the other. Yeah. Oh, yes, of course. Celebrating
person.
John,
Absolutely.
Who's always been the most wonderful
Absolutely.
Man. Yes.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yes. I totally agree. My director, unlike your sweetheart, was the wonderful Guy Hamilton.
Oh,
sadly
okay.
now,
oh,
no
yes.
longer here.
Yes.
But wonderful man, and I did in fact see him again a few years ago, and he remembered me. And my dim little scene as Miss Caruso.
Aww.
What a lovely chap. But John is out of this world.
Isn't he just?
Oh. I think, I believe Guy Hamilton, am I right, only did the one Bond? I'm not absolutely sure about that.
We'll need to get the boffins on that one.
Yeah, we
Listen,
yes.
thank you guys so, so much. It's been
Great
wonderful
pleasure.
To meet with you, and I can't wait to have a little socialise with you later.
Good, lovely. Thank you.
So
really good.
Thanks for watching, guys. Be sure to follow the club on social media across all of our channels and become a member if you haven't already to become a 00.